quarterback, there is nothing like having a good tight end. Because you know why? Because he's close to you. So it doesn't take great skill to throw the ball 5 or 6 yards from where you're at to a tight end who can catch it nowadays. And not only just catch the ball, get you about 10 or 15 extra yards running with it.
Manning out of the gun. It's complete to Todd Gurley. Gurley's tackled down at the 36. So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. Gurley's handed the football. Brought down by Redding. Now that we've got a moment, let's look at the Rams' offense. A week ago, they had no ability to hold on to the football, giving it away 4 times. Third and one. Fullback takes the handoff. They're able to move the chains after that last run. Manning's lined up. 2 tight ends set. Hit, throws. And now, here's the Cardinals defense. They never got to the quarterback once last week. The Rams come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. And it's incomplete. Just can't hold on that time. This defense is ready to pounce here early in this game as a third and long play is coming up.
They sure are. There's no doubt about that. They got themselves in a good situation here. If I'm the quarterback now, third and long, I would be very cautious and conservative.
The Rams will take the snap from the 40. Kendricks got it on a pass that had some heat. The Rams come to the line. Of course, plenty of pink on the field today and in the stands, as all of October we'll be seeing this for Breast Cancer Awareness Month in the NFL. Drop back, shotgun formation. And they get the sack.
The offensive line that time had no idea this quarterback was coming on the blitz. He timed it perfectly, and the speed and the talent to get there, and he gets the sack on the QB.
The Rams lined up, bunch formation.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
It's intercepted. He's brought down. You hate to dig an early hole, but that's what's happened here with the early interception throw.
Yeah, good job on the defense, but I'll tell you, you got to make sure as a quarterback when you throw an interception early in the game that you don't let it get into your head and get self-doubt. So stay positive, go out there, be aggressive, and play that way.
From the 32 to the ground for about 4. And now we'll look at the Cardinals' offense. They will be expecting far greater efficiency today. A week ago, they turned it over on 3 occasions. And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down.
Right now.
Johnson's going to secure the handoff. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Johnson's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has 3 more chances.
Carson Palmer takes a look down from under center. First down at the 46. Johnson's on the toss. Gets the football. The Cardinals will take the snap from the 45. He was looking short, but the pass falls incomplete. And now here's the Rams defense. This is a ball-hawking unit that a week ago came up with four takeaways. Third down now. The Cardinals will set up. The 44 is the first down line. Johnson is ready to run off the screen.
When you're in a situation like this, it's third and long. What do you think the defense is going to guard against? Long pass down the field. That's right. So it's very obvious. And that time, nobody's open down the field. So the pass goes incomplete.
No chance to return this one as that punt is headed to the sidelines. The Rams were moving the football the last time they had it, only to give the football away on the pick. Let's see how they do it this time.
Yeah, you know, that's a tough situation for the offense. You get a little confidence and you're moving the football, and then the turnover just changes everything. So you got to find a way to get your confidence going again.
Catch made near the sideline. That's his first reception today. First down, about 3.5 minutes to go here in the first. First down and 10. Gurley's taking the handoff. Second down and 11. Almost intercepted. We're early in this one, but already a crucial third and long play coming up.
These are tough situations. What are you going to do on the offensive side? There's only so much you can do. If I was the defense, I would look for a screen.
The Rams need to get to the 35 to pick up a first. The Rams take it from the 23. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, it's a game of chances in the NFL. It's third down. The defensive coordinator said, let's get after this quarterback. He sends the extra guys. He blitzes him, and they get there before the quarterback can react.
And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds. Trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. Here they come to the 41-yard line.
When you see linebackers moving like this, you're trying to confuse the offensive line.
At the line of scrimmage, the 41.
Get ready. Blues 58.
Palmer's back in shotgun formation. Larry Fitzgerald has the catch. And Fitzgerald's marked down at the 34.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he could catch it. And the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just short of the first down.
Mirror, mirror, mirror. Deep, deep.
Third and 3. Catch made. Johnson's tackled down after a gain of 12.
So many things are involved when you talk about people catching the pass. Catch it cleanly.
also catch it and break a tackle. Everybody loves that. Nice job that time.
Heading to the line at the 22. First down at the 22. Johnson's going to take the handoff now. After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8.
Defensive tackles, we always think of them as run stoppers. How about this that time? He does a great job, gets in there, and sacks the quarterback.
The defense just mauling the quarterback. It'll be 3rd and 16 after the sack. He'll take the snap from the gun. Looking middle that time, and it's incomplete.
The Cardinals don't have a lot of options on 3rd and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
The kick, and it's through there. The kick is good. We're late in the first, and that field goal puts them on top.
Yes, and it's a confidence boost, no question about it. When you get a field goal or a touchdown late in the first quarter and it puts you on top, it just feels good.
And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Rams line up, split backfield. The Rams from the 22. Mason's got it on the screen. Tackle made by Ray that time.
Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws, sooner or later that defense is going to come up, and when they come up, that's when you throw it over the top.
That was a nice reception, but not enough for the first down. Second down coming up.
D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting a run up the middle. Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Manning uncorks a long pass, and they can't connect. On the way, 3rd down. Peyton Manning under center. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Rams will second guess that play call. That time on 3rd and short. They throw the football. Everybody thought they were going to run it. They were trying to be too clever, and it backfired. Now it's 4th down.
And that's a 2-yard gain.
Well, returning punts is a tough job. It's about judgment. That time, that was poor judgment by the return man. Should have just had a fair catch and never tried to return that.
The Cardinals stepping back onto the field to get this next drive underway. Their previous possession was a field goal.
Yeah, I think they feel good about that field goal. They made some good plays, and they got down there, and they moved the football, and they got in position where they could kick the field goal. Now you take the knowledge that you gained from that last drive, use it, and try to go down there now and score a touchdown.
They've got to be wondering, though, can they finish off a drive today? Second down now. Carson Palmer throws the long pass, and it's incomplete.
Quarterback has a strong arm, but I am starting to question his touch. Need a little more touch on those deep passes. That time he overthrows the receiver.
It's third down coming up. Looks like they're in press coverage here. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. And that incompletion is going to bring us to a very quick fourth down. The Cardinals will punt the football. And that punt is going out of bounds. They are not going to allow them to return it. The Rams got absolutely nothing out of their previous possession. And here they are back on the field. Another three and out, I would have to think, would be very demoralizing to this team right now, Phil.
Yeah, it's going to be demoralizing to the offense. But I'll tell you who's going to be more demoralized is the defense, because they need to sit on the sidelines and get a little rest. So I know there's a lot of pressure on this offense right now.
Made by Ray that time. That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. First down at the 25. He'll throw it over the middle. Brian Quick has the catch. Pass complete, but did not get them the first, so it's second down now. The Cardinals sat at the line. Dime package. Gurley's got it on the handle. And that's a gain of 13.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Moving it to the other side of the field at the 49. First and 10. Toss to the outside. Gurley's met after a gain of 8.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Again, they'll lean on him. Gurley's marked down at the 41.
The Cardinals' defense is so fast and so powerful. That time on the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle the runner for a loss.
Third down. From the gun, reaches up to make the catch. Coming to the line at the 38. An extra tight end on the field for this one. First and 10. Trying to fight through right up the middle of the field. Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
Bounce, bounce.
The corner step back. Quick drop back. And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. That's his third catch of the day. The line of scrimmage right at the 24. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Buchanan's there to take it down.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense. Look what the defensive line is doing. They're all pinching down inside. They're expecting a run.
Knocked down as he fires it. About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. The Rams get set at the line, needing to get to the 14 for a first. And incomplete. Didn't get his feet down. Lining up here, looking to tie the game on this field goal try. And he puts it through for three. That field goal has the game back to even midway through the second quarter.
Yeah, because the score's tied. And look, I think both sides are probably disappointed that they're tied with the other team because they've had opportunities. They haven't taken advantage of them. And that's why we are sitting here midway in the second quarter with the tie game.
And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Cardinals offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest.
Completion to Fitzgerald. Gains 18. That's another reception, given two.
Well, as you saw that receiver make the catch, I'll just say this. You cannot throw the football enough his way. There's no such thing. When in doubt, you don't like anything, turn and find him and throw it to him.
2 minutes to go in the first half and a first down. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. First down at the 47. Aaron Donald with the sack.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The Cardinals snap it at the 41. On the money. Nowhere to go, as this will be a loss of three.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Now looking at third down.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Palmer's got it in the gun. Looking across the middle. No surprise, it's another third down stop, and this has been a first half where both of these defenses have had the upper hand, Phil.
Yeah, it's been physical, it's been fast, and it's been good. Now I'm talking about the defenses. On the offense, the best thing they've done is not make a major mistake to put their team in a hole, so the second half is going to be interesting to watch.
And Austin is brought down. And a run back. of about 10.
The Rams bring their offense onto the field. The last time they had control of the football, they did not come away empty-handed, but did not get a touchdown either.
Well, they got that field goal, and I think that's important. That field goal gave them a little confidence. They got some points up there. That always makes you feel good on the offensive side. Now take advantage of that good feeling. Go out there and score a touchdown this time.
Let's see if they can finish off a drive.
That's a gain of 10. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
So right into the hurry-up offense they go, into this two-minute situation.
Yeah, these guys, all these pros, they've been doing this stuff since they were in high school running the two-minute offense, so I know they're ready for it.
Quarters formation here for the defense. In on the tackle.
As we near halftime, the offense has the opportunity to grab the lead heading into the break.
Well, I don't like their chances, and really both of these teams has been pretty sorry play so far here in the first half. They both deserve to go in at halftime tied.
The Cardinals are going to line up. Close game, second quarter. The score's 3-3.
Get ready.
First down at the 44. Almost intercepted. Second and 10. Gresham can't bring it in. That'll probably go as a drop.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. Palmer's going to take it from the gun. Ball is out. The defense has the football. Just before halftime, and the defense with the fumble recovery has set up the offense now for a possible quick strike and the lead at the intermission.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. I love watching great defense. That's what we saw that time. You, on the other hand, it's always about the offense. You want to be entertained, but I like the physical part of
defense. The Rams are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. The Rams moving inside the 20 and the red zone. Last week, they just feasted on that part of the field.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
And it's batted down.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
They break huddle at the 18-yard line.
Second down and 10. Toss play. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day.
So far, wonderful execution in this drive. When you get a chance to get out of bounds, here the offensive player got the yardage, had a chance, gets out of the bound, stops the clock. Good job by the offense.
Manning's got everybody split out wide. First and goal from the 4. Intercepted. A late second quarter interception could certainly change the tenor of this game, Phil, as we head near halftime.
Oh, it really can. I'll tell you, the game, it's tied, all that. You're thinking the worst is going to happen to us. We're going to go in at halftime tied. And now, all of a sudden, if this offense can take advantage of this opportunity, that will change everything going inside.
What a difficult spot to be in from here. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. The Cardinals are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. first down with their backs to their own end zone. This will be the last play before halftime.
Get ready. Move, and hold.
Takes the knee. And they'll try to conserve time here with this timeout. Second down and in a very precarious spot. They immediately call for a timeout. One more snap and halftime.
Let's go.
Palmer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Jumps high and comes down with it. The first half is complete. Larry Ridley is ready to take things over back in our studios. And you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The second half is underway. Which offense will create separation first? That's the question. That return's good for about 27. The Cardinals come out onto the field, now looking to get something positive going here to take the lead in this game, Phil, as we start the second half.
Yeah, they would like to do that. Of course, you always want to take the lead, but when you get into the second half and you get on top, man, that starts to put the pressure on the other team. So that's their thinking. I think they will come out here and be very aggressive to start the second half.
And that's a gain of 10.
The Cardinals did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Here's the handoff. Johnson's brought down after picking up only a yard.
Johnson's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First and 10. Johnson's handed the football. McDonald's all over the ball carrier.
The Rams guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
Here we go.
The Cardinals have it at the 34.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
The Cardinals have it at the 34. This will go incomplete. He was trying to find Floyd. Defense was the order of the first half, Phil Simms, and it's hard to even see a scenario where that doesn't continue.
I think we got a trend going here. Here we are in the third quarter, and the offenses are still locked up, can't do anything. I don't care. I like this. Defenses rule today.
Austin's going to take this one from the 30. And Weatherspoon in on the tackle. And a run back of about 13. The Rams back onto the field. Of course, the last drive they had it. It looked like they were going to put up some points. Only to watch the football get picked off in opponent's territory.
Smart defensive coach they're going against in this game today. He knows how to put his players in positions to make plays. And he did that last drive, and they came up with the INT.
Was that on the quarterback, or was that just a great play by the defender?
I'm giving most of the credit to the defender. It's just a good play.
After the pass play, gain 7. Second and 3 on the way.
Gurley's going to secure the handoff.
And that gains a few. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day. This is third down.
They're trying to confuse the offense here. Look at everybody crowd the line of scrimmage.
Gurley's taking the handoff. No one's going to get him now. First down here after the run.
Well, when you have a tie game and you're down in the red zone, you can do whatever you want. You can fool them with a run here, or you can take a chance and throw the football in the end zone to get a score.
You got to be quick and decisive when you're down near the goal line and you're throwing the pass as a quarterback. That timing was not, and he takes a huge sack.
Loss of 4 on the play.
Stepping up to the line at the 10-yard line.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Tight end in motion.
Second and goal from the 10-yard line.
Has to extend for that one, and he's got it.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I just spoke with a Cardinals official. He does have an upper body injury of some kind, but guys, it doesn't appear to be a big concern. The medical staff's cleared him to return as soon as he feels ready. Back to you.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Manning with the give. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
This will be a field goal attempt from 41 yards out. The kick is through for 3.
And that kick here midway through the third quarter puts them in front.
It's great to get the lead anytime in the third quarter of a football game, but you got to think, they're over there going, boy, we hope this doesn't cost us the fact that we did not get 7 points on that drive.
Nelson's going to test the coverage this time. Lynch is there that time for the tackle. That return's good for about 21.
The Cardinals heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative. Get the defense off guard. Make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
Carson Palmer takes a look down from under center. Johnson's going to take the handoff now. Gaines is there to take him down.
That was a power running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Let's go. Second down and 4. The Cardinals get a first down.
The Cardinals look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Palmer's completion percentage, 40% on the day. First down at the 38. Takes it out of the eye. Johnson's tackled down at the 39.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
The Cardinals have it at the 39. Brings it into his body. Johnson's brought down after picking up just a yard.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
Let's go, Quiet, 18.
The Cardinals will take the snap from the 40. Incomplete. The hit jarred the ball loose.
And partner, with this third quarter coming to an end, this game's been devoid of a whole lot of offensive fireworks.
Defense has been the name of the game out here so far today. Kind of fun to watch. Both of them doing a good job and just physically winning the battle against the offense.
And the punt is kicked out of bounds.
The Rams step back onto the field on offense. Their last possession resulted in a field goal.
Well, I know this. It was good defense on the other side. That's what made them kick that field goal. So the defense is feeling good about the fact that they stopped that momentum by the offense and made them kick that field goal.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Campbell's all over that offense and brings him down.
Rams running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Peyton Manning from the shotgun. And incomplete. What a hit that time.
Well, it's do or die right now, and you've got to go ahead and make the call to give your offense a chance to get this first down. And I know this team, they have a lot at their disposal. I think there's a play in there that's going to give them a good chance.
After the incomplete pass, it's third down. The Rams come to the line with a bunch set. The Rams now moves the chains. And a flag is down.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space. And sometimes, accidentally, you're going to grab the face mask.
First down and 10. Gurley's got it on the handoff.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
They call his name again. They tackle him for a loss.
Interesting situation here for the offense. They got a lead here in the second half, but it's third long, and I always like to say, the football is in the hands of the quarterback, so he has to be smart. If he tries to force it down the field, I do not like his chances.
Mason, the lone setback this time. Third and 10. Very nearly intercepted.
The Rams really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Nelson's going to take this one from the 6. So here we go, partner. The fourth quarter about to get underway, and you feel like the next offense that scores is going to end up winning the game.
Oh, I think so. When you think about this, my gosh, it's been so difficult and so hard for the offenses to do anything. So if somebody can come up with a new thought process here, make that one big play down the field, that's the team that's going to win. The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
On the receiving end, it's Fitzgerald.
The Cardinals, good job that time, moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
First down at the 27. Throws the pass, and there's a drop.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot, and the throw goes incomplete.
Get ready. New 95. Regular.
The Cardinals from the 27. Palmer looking down the field.
When you get in a situation like this as a quarterback, it's in the second half, it's third and long, you're losing a close game, it's up to you to make the right decision. Don't force the issue. If it's not there, throw it short or throw it away.
Palmer's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Finds Gresham. That'll pick up the first. And finally, the offense comes through with a clutch on third down. That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. It's caught by John Brown. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play.
Palmer's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Second and short. He'll throw it over the middle. Another takeaway. That brings the play to an end. Still a lot of time to go in this fourth quarter, but you'd have to think a score here would put them in a great position to win the game.
Oh, no question about that. I'm just going to go back to the interception. What was the QB thinking? Understand where you are in the game. To take a chance like that here early in the fourth quarter is just unacceptable.
Double tight end formation. First down at the 41. That's a tackle at the 48. That's 5 receptions on the day. After the pass play, gain 7. 2nd and 3 on the way. The Cardinals lined up in the nickel. They'll run it here. Gurley's tackled down at the 50. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day. Now 3rd and short following the run. Gurley's lined up as the single back. Here's the handoff and they'll run it. Another 3rd down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
Rams offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up.
First down at the 48. Feeds him again.
He didn't get many yards that time on that run, but he's had a terrific day. When there's an opportunity to get some yards, he's been there to take advantage of it.
2nd down after going to the ground game the first play. The Cardinals defense now is going to go nickel. They'll run it with him again. The tackle's made and the 1st down is picked up.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up 1st downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The Rams come out. Jumbo package on the field. The Rams from the 37. Picks up about 5.
If it was me, I would cover the short receivers and force this guy to throw it down the field. You're behind by a few points. You've got to try and force the issue.
And here we have 2nd down. Manning's lined up. Empty backfield. From the gun. The Rams get a 1st down.
There's no doubt time of possession can be an overrated stat in games many times. But one thing you want to do, throw and catch it just like this to pick up those 1st downs and keep it going. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
1st and goal from the 5. Picked up a couple that time.
Well, that last play almost got them in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Second and goal from the three. Mason's brought down after picking up only a yard.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Only 2 yards to go to pay dirt. The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. Another hit, takes it across, and he's in for the touchdown.
Well, the defense knew that they were probably going to see a run here in third and goal, and what do? They don't, it doesn't matter. They still get blown off the line of scrimmage by the offensive line. Nice job.
He's put the ball on the tee, and he's about to kick off. Nelson's going to test the coverage here. The Cardinals offense back on the field, trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Michael Floyd calls it in. Second down after that pass play. Now they're in the hurry up. From the shotgun. Looking long. And he knocks the ball out of his hands. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. Trailing. Every third down so big at this point. The Cardinals have it at the 39. It's intercepted, and that's going to end the comeback attempt. On his way, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
I think it's something that's not...
Well, it played out as if it was a pick, but... Upstairs, they want to take another look to confirm it.
Well, that was an awesome play by the defense that time, getting the interception. Now, they turn into receivers once they get the interception. Did he have possession of the football? We'll find out.
Nelson's going to run this one out. Tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Cardinals offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
The Cardinals take it from the 28. John Brown brings it down. Brown's got the first as he's brought down. Holding on to the timeout. They'll rush back to the line. Dropping back now into the shotgun. Intercepted! Phil, can you believe the defense steps up and makes the interception to clinch it for him today?
Oh, they love this. Nothing like winning a game with a defensive play to ice everything. And I give the defense all the credit. Just a great play on their part.
And picks up maybe 3 or 4.
Great call here by the coach in this situation. Keep running the football. Keep that clock moving. You have the lead. Just tell your quarterback to tell everybody on offense this. Hold on to the football and don't have a penalty where you could stop that clock.
It's now 2nd down and 7 after the 3-yard rush.
Blue side, blue side, blue
did not beat the play clock. Takes the knee. It'll be third down. One more snap and we can call it a day. Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you. And how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same, that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you. But that's just not the case. But, no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe. So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.